I've been traveling a lot, which has been fun. I just went to Vancouver, Canada, which was a good time. I stayed downtown, so I stayed, like, the hotel. It was great. You can just look into people's apartments. Like, no one shuts their window blinds. So that, like, becomes your whole weekend. You're just looking into... And when you spy on people, you want to see them have sex or a murder. Like, that's it. Like, anything else, you're like, these are the worst people I've ever... Just no life, you know? No life. I did a show, and one night I was going to go eat, and I was by myself. So I'm walking up this street, Davie Street. And as I'm heading up, it's like pretty late. It's like a lot of bars. I'm walking up, and I see a guy crossing the street, and he's staring at me. So I'm like staring back at him, and he just keeps staring and keep walking towards me. So I just keep walking forward. And then he stops in the sidewalk and just continues to stare at me. So now I'm like looking over my shoulder, staring at him to make sure, because like this guy's trying to fight me is what he's trying to do. So I'm looking over my shoulder, looking at him. And then I look forward and I'm going the wrong way. So then I was like, oh, great. So now I got to walk back towards this guy. So I'm walking back towards him. He's still there, still staring at me. So I was like, I don't want to fight him. So I was like, I got to do something. So what I came up with, I was like, I'm going to go talk to him first. I'm going to just say something, try to diffuse whatever tension we have. So I like get close to him and I just walk. I go, hey, what's up, man? How are you doing tonight? And it was enough that he was like, what? And he like moved over. And then I walked by him. I was like, all right, let's hope that worked. So I looked over my shoulder to see if it worked. It did not. He was now following me. It was almost like I just built confidence up in his head. And he was like, I look forward to fighting this guy now. So I'm just watching him follow me. And then I get to a corner and I turn the corner. And I look at him one more time, like this time to invite him to be like, look, if you want to fight, let's just fight, all right? So I look at him, then I go to where he can't see me anymore behind the corner, then I run and hide behind a car like a dude does. I see him turn the corner and he's like looking everywhere for me. And I was like, that's when I realized like that guy was going to kill me. Like that's where my head goes. It's like, he was trying to kill me. So eventually he leaves, I get up off the ground, I go back to the hotel. The next day at the club, I tell them the whole story. And, you know, I was like, follow me, what's going on? And I was like, what's going on at Davie Street? Are people just like fighting there a lot? Or do y'all have a serial killer maybe loose? Because I might have found him last night. And they're like, where were you at? I was like, Davie Street. And they were like, oh, you know, Davie Street's like the gay street, right? And I was like, what? And they go, it's like the gay area. And they were like, I was like, well, I don't even know what that means. They're like, well, he was probably just hitting on you. I was like, well, that seems like a pretty intense way to hit on someone, to follow them and scare them. Like, if I ever hit on a girl and, like, I wouldn't drive home behind her, like, flashing my lights at her, and, like, the cops show up, and you're like, well, I didn't know she was going to be a bitch about this, officer. I thought this was how you hit on women, by scaring them. And then they tell me there's another unspoken rule they have on that street that the gay guys, that if they want to do it with each other, they just stare at each other for 5 seconds. So if you stare at another guy for 5 seconds and neither one of y'all just keep staring, that means y'all want to go do it. So they were like, how many seconds do you think you stared at him? I was like, oh, probably like 900 seconds, like a ton of seconds, like way more than I just want to do it. Like I stared at him like, I would like you to meet my family and... We've got to figure a way to tell my wife I'm moving to Vancouver for you. Like, we have a lot of stuff we got to do tonight. That's when I realized I just broke that guy's heart. That's all I did to that guy. I just broke his heart. Because, like, from his perspective, he's doing nothing wrong. Like, he is just walking on Gay Street where everybody's just doing everybody at the drop of a hat. And he sees a single guy walking who, you know, he probably called pretty. And he's like, where is this beautiful man going? And as I'm walking away from him, I'm staring at him over my shoulder, which is probably a tease in his world. That's probably teasing. Just walking away, staring at him. And he's like, why will he not come back towards me? Then I just turn around and start walking back towards him. He's like, is this going to happen? I hope it gives me a sign. And then I walk up to him and go, hey, how are you doing tonight? What's up? And then I walk by. He's like, should I follow you? And then I'm staring at him again over my shoulder like, yeah, you should follow me. I thought I delivered a pretty good message there that I want this to happen. And he's like, where are we going to do it? There's like people out here. And that's when I turn a corner and I go, we'll go right down here. There's not that many people down here. This is where most people do it, down here. And then I hid from him. I probably like, he probably thought I vanished and was like, is this guy a magician or something? Like, he's like, no, my dad is though. That's how I got away. It's great, like I can mark, like Canada, I know where Canada's at as far as a country. I have a pretty good idea.